And thank you for joining us live. You are again back in Birmingham, England, with Bob Noxious and my good friend Smack Daddy. Smack Daddy and I go way back now, about 2 days.
All the way back to yesterday afternoon.
Yeah.
It's a long-standing friendship, probably the longest standing on the entire crew.
Exactly. But we're going to bring to you today what's going to be a very good bout. We've got Team Canada that's playing. Team Canada, of course, has yet to lose a game. Team Wales, who has, let's face it, exceeded expectations.
They put in a fantastic performance against Team USA yesterday and had this crowd in an absolute frenzy.
Oh,
I expect a lot more of the same from them today.
Yeah, and for those of you back, especially in the United States, you're not used to the kind of noise that we get when we come to Europe and we do the international games. It is deafening. There are times that even with the headsets on that Smack Daddy and I can't hear ourselves.
I think we're going to have to look into moving these tables further back from the crowd because we just get drowned in sound. Don't get me wrong, it's a fantastic feeling because it creates such an amazing atmosphere. But it's so easy to just get caught up in what's going on right in front of you. I mean, the crowds throughout all of yesterday for every single game over all the tracks in the building was amazing.
Absolutely. I tell you what, they're doing equipment checks right now. Maybe we could try to get in the rosters just before the national anthems. And if you want to go ahead, my friend, and start with Wales.
Yeah, we'll give you a quick rundown through Team Wales. Number one for them is Manwaring. 117, roll call. Number 17, my lucky number, is Jenkins. 218, 218, Longworth. Number 254 is Jones. 2828, Ashton. 2X4, Creighton Griffiths. Number 3 is Hayes. 36, Phillips. Number 43, Clark. Number 79 is The Mechanic. Fantastic skater with some great technical ability. Number 9, Malatinsky. FE26 is Meredith. And HK86, Clements. That's your Team Wales for this bout.
And Team Canada for this bout is number 0. That is Eltonine. Number 12 is Walker. 13-13 is Dr. T. Sanchez. Number 16 is Marty Gras. Number 38, Fluster Cluck. Number 4, Stand Aside. 5 is Red. 6 is Quiet Riot. 6 is Titchborn. 71 is the Rev. And I tell you what, we're going to take it to the national anthem right now.
Okay then, folks, remain standing for now is the national anthem of Wales.
Oh,
And as they start to line them up, one of the things that we do need to explain to you is that we are now into full-length bouts. They are back to having the usual number of timeouts. We are back to our normal scenario when it comes to official timeouts. Quickly, let me finish the roster for Canada. Number 84 is Gray Gustav, 9-11 Homer Jensey, F-22 Bradass, and M-4 Tank. And Smack Daddy, my friend, let's get this ball a-rolling.
Indeed, as we get the first jam underway, we would like to say hello to Bailey on Twitter, who's had major anxiety for his Team Wales up against Team Canada.
Well, I don't think he needs to have major anxiety right now, as number 254 is going to be out in front. That's going to be Jones.
Quick skip through the inside, quick few points on the board for Team Wales, calls it off smart, gets some points on the board, first blood goes to Team Wales.
You're absolutely right, Smack Daddy. Right now, when you're playing a team like Team Canada, you got to take what you can get, and you cannot take chances. You got to play by the textbook.
You've got to play smart and simple. Don't try anything too fancy. Keep yourself set, keep yourself on track, keep your skaters on track.
And don't give up unnecessary points.
Exactly. And it's a lot easier to protect your score with all four blockers still
exactly.
on track.
We've got Bradass out there right now for Team Canada. For Wales, we've got Ashton. And oh my God, look at that. We've got Bradass out there in a hurry.
Straight, he's quick out of the blocks and off like a shot. Interesting thing about Bradass, he's actually part of a father and son team for
yes.
Team Canada. Him and Rice Ball, father and son.
Yes, I know.
That's a first for me. I've never seen something like that. Bradass completes another pass. Another mention on Twitter now. Best and most rousing national anthem so far goes to Team Wales, apparently.
And we're going to get one of the, we're going to get the Team Wales pivots going to get called off for a foul. And that's going to end that jam. We'll have a score update here for you in a moment.
Indeed, pivot taking a seat in the box was number 117. That's roll call for Team Wales.
And it looks like that's going to be, it looks like Bradass is going to go for two grand slams, put them up 10-2, Team Canada. First period, 27 minutes left.
Looks like we've got the mechanic now jamming for Team Wales, number 79. This could be an interesting one.
And number five, Red. And a lot of jostling around coming off the jammer line. And Red is really stuck behind a really nice two wall by Wales. Going to get forced to the inside. They're going to drive him back.
Some strong block in there just knocks him off the inside line. The mechanic jukes round on the outside, spins off the last block, adjusted and panting. He takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
Oh, I tell you, Smack Daddy, that was a fantastic move.
He's so quick on his skates. He jukes, he moves, he spins, he turns, he never stops moving. His feet keep going. Another couple of points on the board and calls the jam off.
Yeah, he comes in heavy into a three wall, realizes he's not going to get through it without giving up points. Calls the jam, takes the 2 points. Very, very smart move.
It's not always about passing all the opposing blockers.
No.
As soon as you've got the points on the board, protect your own score, call the jam and save it.
And I think sometimes that is really a difficult thing mentally for a jammer to get into their head.
Looking at this one now, it looks like we're starting with a power jam situation for Team Canada. I'm not sure what happens at the end of that one there, but they've taken full advantage. Number 12, Walker goes through and takes lead jammer for Canada.
Nice job with the two wall. Unfortunately, a little over-assertive.
Hayes tries to bowl Clark into Walker, force him off on the inside. Didn't quite come off for him that time.
Oh, look at that communication. Walker telling him what it is he wants, what he's looking for. Oh, look at the spin move coming out of the first turn.
Mid-block, mid-turn, spins and just sets off again at a rate of knots.
But there he comes in awfully hard. Yeah, he's gonna get a cut track.
Oh, that was harsh. He was down and quick back up onto his feet, but unfortunately just left track as the block happened.
Yeah, and it could have been one of a number of things too, I think, Smack Daddy. That could have been a forearm, that could have been a back block. Either way, he was gonna get called for something.
Looks like the mechanic had been released from the sim, but as you mentioned earlier, he comes into the back of the pack so hard, he just came in with a back walk, and he's straight back into the sim bin again for another 1 minute stint.
And we all love that moment where there really isn't a jammer on the track.
A little bit of confusion going on, I think.
Well, actually, I believe they have to let them... This is part of the game. It doesn't happen very often. It does happen to be the second time it's happened today. But there, he will finish the initial...
Initial
penalty.
He would have been released initially with the mechanic coming straight back in, but because the mechanic had been serving his penalty at the start of this jam, Walker has no choice but to serve the rest of his time.
Yeah, it's kind of an odd rule. It doesn't come up very often, but he does have to finish. He does have to finish the first penalty.
Yep. Walker doing his best to get the crowd riled as he goes round the outside at the end of that jam. Just a little bit of a cheer, a little bit of a hand wave, trying to get his Team Canada fans making as much noise as they humanly can. I don't think they need much encouragement, to be fair, but every little helps, I suppose.
You know, one thing we've talked about earlier is Team Canada, is we're going to get I believe it's going to be an official timeout.
Yep, looks like they're just wanting to clarify something, I think, with some of the other NSOs from the bout.
But one of the things that's really, really interesting about Canada comes in with about 8 or 9 different guys from 8 or 9 different leagues.
Yeah.
Obviously, men's derby very well developed in Canada. I think that if we were to, I dare say, speculate, we have seen that Team USA, Team Canada, Team Australia, Team England, you know, the places where derby probably, women's derby first set their feet is where we're seeing the men's derby having done the same.
That's where it's really starting to take off. You compare that to the guys from Team Wales, a large percentage of their skaters now, I believe about sort of 80% of their skaters in Team Wales all play for the same team in Wales, the South Wales Silurys.
And we've just received a note that Team Argentina, who has been such a tremendous surprise in this tournament, is now down to 4 active players.
That's got to be so hard for Team Argentina to take. We found out yesterday as well the result of, obviously we all heard Ninja Pan skater Sho was away to the hospital yesterday. We sent our best wishes out to him for an injury.
Yes.
He has came back. He is not actively able to skate now, unfortunately.
No.
Does have his arm in a sling, but at least he's back now and still able to support his team at the side. Gave a great rendition of Team Ninja Pan's national anthem earlier. He was rousing on his knees with his one good arm flailing around.
Yeah.
We hope that all of Team Argentina skaters are holding up well as well.
Yeah. Team Argentina and Team Japan, obviously the two darlings of this tournament. Team Japan has just been probably overwhelmed. The love from the crowd, it doesn't matter who they play. They could be playing the United States, they could be playing Canada. The crowd around that track is enormous. And when they come off the track, when you see other players skate by and slap hands, these guys like stop and shake every hand.
We had an experience earlier when they were playing against Team Ireland, earlier this morning. One of Team Ireland had an issue with one of his knee pads. Something came off. And as U2 was jamming for Team Japan, he actually stopped, picked up the item that came off and put it in his pocket mid-jam to finish the jam off before going to the Team Ireland skater, I think it was Ab Norman, afterwards to return the item that had fallen from
that's
him.
That's awesome.
I mean, you see these guys, when they are issued with penalties, they actually nod to the referees and say, okay, thank you. And they acknowledge that the referee's there. They may not always understand. I know a lot of them don't have great English. They do have a representative who does most of their speaking for them.
Yeah.
But they're just so polite about everything. They're absolute gentlemen and a joy to have as part of this inaugural Men's Roller Derby World Cup.
Absolutely. And what people have to understand is there is no... they don't come from various men's leagues in Japan. They are the men's
they
league.
They are just... And I think that what they've done here at this tournament is going to do so much to grow the sport of men's roller derby in Japan. I can see... well, next time we have this tournament, I think they're going to come over with more than a full roster.
Well, I think we have to face it and say how many different major leagues that are here today are going to jump at the opportunity to go to Japan and work with these guys and try to help recruit. And it's,
I know a few local teams, just not national teams, actual local skating teams who have said they want, they'll pay themselves if necessary to bring Ninjapan back over and just play them in a game. A standard game, Ninjapan against a normal league team. They just want these guys to get more and more experience. And it's the good old Derby family, Derby community, Derby love being shown.
And on the flip side of that, we have Argentina. And Argentina comes in really, very much, also very much an unknown. Wins their first game, has played competitively, has really had a pretty good tournament until they've just gotten to the point where they're basically out of players.
I think we can now get clarification on what it was that the officials wanted to discuss there during that official timeout. It was to do with the two jammers. Bob, have you got more information from it?
Well, I don't know that we've got a decision made here. Well, we do. Apparently, okay, the skater known as Red for Canada was released too soon. And that apparently is where this comes in.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to start this next jam now with both jammers in the penalty box for both teams now. It looks like Red is standing now, though he will be released first for Team Canada. No, it's Walker, I apologize. Walker's been released now.
Oh, Walker, nice move right there. And I tell you, Smack Daddy, we've seen this all weekend. This, I don't want to say kid, but this guy. Oh, look at that leap.
Oh, beautiful.
The lateral movement and the footwork of this young man is absolutely amazing, as we saw just there.
A fantastic apex jump from Walker, and a big hit at the end from Jenkins forces him off track. So many other skaters would take a hit like that off track at that speed and be into the crowd in the blink of an eye. Walker still has all his wits about him to put the brakes on.
I'd be sliding all the way into another country by now.
I'd probably be out the door. There'd be fire alarms going off as I crash through the exit.
Except the problem is nobody come to get us.
No, this is very true. No one cares about us. We're not special enough.
We got Brad S out there right now for Canada. Who got Wales, my friend?
We've got Meredith, FE26, jamming now for Team Wales. I think this is his first jam so far for this game.
And Meredith, look, he's going to find some room on the inside. Nice three wall by Canada.
Meredith trying his hardest to push up. Big block again, takes him off the inside track. He's recycled, forced all the way to the back. Bradass takes full advantage through the inside line and takes lead for Team Canada.
The thing about Team Canada is they've not shown themselves to be flashy, and probably because they haven't had to.
Yeah.
They play a very disciplined, solid game, and they are big. They are big guys for the most part.
I've heard from a lot of fans who are down here in Birmingham for this tournament who have said that Team Canada look like their logo. They are a gigantic group of lumberjacks, but ironically, it would take someone that size to break down some of the walls that they throw up.
And apparently, I understand that Walker's mom and dad are in the crowd to support him.
Oh.
Yeah, my parents stayed home.
Yeah.
We got zero. That's El Tanan. And El Tanan, who has done, he looks like a big blocker. This guy is one bad arse jammer.
He is, and he's big. Jones just skips around, keeps his toe stop on the inside line. How did he still stay on track for that?
That was awesome, because holding up El Tanan as a jammer is difficult enough. Oh!
Jones footwork once again, just spots a gap on the outside, jukes round, takes the line, calls the jam. The man's quick.
Yeah, it's too bad this isn't any fun. Yeah, you're listening to Bob Noxious and Smack Daddy. I just kind of strolled over here from Madison, Wisconsin.
I took a long drive from Aberdeen, Scotland to make down for this one.
Yeah, he was supposed to have a plane. Yeah. Right out there right now for Canada.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Just as he went round the inside, step back onto track. Team Wales jammer now will take his seat in the sin bin, meaning we've got a power jam situation for Team Canada. Red works his way around nicely and takes lead jammer for them.
Oh, look at that. Nice wall formation up front by Wales.
Doing their best just to hold off, trying to
Yep.
Bowls him in beautifully.
Yeah, Red got... Well, who's going to get the cut? I thought Red cut.
No, I think it was Hulse. I think it was Hulse. He went off track at the same time as Red did, but came back in too soon. We've had a message through on Twitter from Hulse saying, Team Canada, beards, nice. I think they are sporting some fantastic beards here.
Look at that! Red puts down a shoulder. And let's remember, when you're skating that direction, your entire torso is a wide open bullseye, which is why in most cases you want to be shoulder to shoulder with a guy when you're blocking that way. You rarely in men's derby see somebody skate and give somebody that shot.
Yeah.
He took it, and that one's going to hurt.
Took it, bounced, but still back up and carried on.
But you know what? He knows what his sternum is now.
Yeah. He knows what it is. Sore. Looks like we've got Jones now trying his hardest. Plows through the middle of the Team Canada wall. Works the crowd up as he comes around the straightaway.
And Walker right in his vapor trail.
He missed! He missed!
That's a whiff! How does that go in the stats? A jammer-on-jammer whiff.
We had a jammer-on-jammer whiff that resulted in Scottish and a jammer-on-jammer skiff. One hit, one missed, and he hit the deck instead. Poor Jones. It was a good idea, just couldn't quite pull it off as he went through. Did the smart thing, though. Didn't get back up, try and force himself back into play.
No, I missed.
I'll call it off.
And you can see how Canada is trying to dominate the jammer line. The rev gets tumbled backwards. And we're going to have another. Of course, again, if you're going to have a jammer that large, it can only be El Tanan.
He is a big, big, big guy. But he's so quick on his feet for a big guy as well. He's got great balance, great technique.
And Smack Daddy, that's a very, very acute observation. And the other thing that he's got going for him is with that larger stride, as we see with so many players, he's moving so much faster than it looks.
There's so many skaters here who you see will take a few strides in the straightaways to propel themselves down into that turn. El Tanan takes about 1.5 strides, and he's down the straightaway and already halfway around the turn.
All I can tell you is if I see that coming, I'm moving out of the way.
I am in no way skating against that. Now, the strange thing is, as El Tanan takes a seat for this jam, he's replaced in pivot position this time by someone who's probably larger.
Yep.
This Canadian team is, I don't know about sort of, you know, lumberjacks. I think they are just trees. These guys are huge, and you can see that in the scoreline. Looks like Team Canada now leading 54-10 against Team Wales as we go through a team timeout.
And 17:23 remaining in the first half. At this point, we've had one team out taken, and that has been by Wales.
Yeah. Give themselves a little bit of a pep talk, get spiced up again for this one. Looks like the mechanics coming back into jam for them now, number 79.
I think he's got his toolbox this time.
He brings it everywhere.
Yeah. Smart man. cordless drill, most important thing you could ever have.
Cordless drill and a spanner.
Yeah.
If you can't fix it with either of those, it's either duct tape or a hammer.
Yeah, I'm with you.
It's like they say, if it can't be fixed with tape, you're not using enough tape. So Brad Ash just taking his time there, sizing up the back of the Team Wales wall.
Mechanic, nice job of leveraging that two wall up front, but they're going to run him down into the ground. And Walker's going to find room on the outside as that two wall kind of collapses.
Bill Mechanic's back on his feet and gets through, completes his initial pass now as well.
And we're going to see Walker with a little skip jump around the apex just enough to pass and put probably four on the board.
Looks like four, I think, being signaled by the jam referee there. Good communication again there from Team Canada. Seeing they have someone sitting in the sin bin now, quick shout out again to their team on track. One more off. Don't want to field too many blockers at the start of a jam, otherwise that will result in more penalties being called.
Yeah. They frown on that. And as you watch that at home, look at just the power and the leveraging, that body leveraging. Oh, look at that! Right down the inside. Say goodbye, it's red.
Drops down low and just powers through a gap. Strong blocking from Roll Call, though, holding off Stand Aside to try and allow his jammer through.
Stand Aside, I think, just said, I've had enough. I know. I've had enough of you.
I'm not going to take the block to move. I'm just going to let you go. I think they call him that because he has to stand aside before anyone can get past him.
That's right. Well, Stand Aside is actually, I believe he is in his 50s. Stand Aside.
51 years old.
And he has, of course, he has been a speed skater for Canada for many, many, many years.
I believe he represented them in roller hockey as well at one point.
Yeah, I believe you're right.
He is a man of many talents, clearly.
Oh, nice move.
Walker again just keeps himself low. The man has such a low stance as he tries to work his way through the back of the wall.
And you know that, and the whole thing about that is we've not seen nearly enough low skating this weekend.
There's a lot of upright stance going on, which is a strange one. I mean, for teams of these caliber, of such a high, I mean, even from the likes of Team Canada and USA at times. There's been a lot of upright stances. I don't know if it's because of the style of floor that they're skating on this time. They're trying to adjust their stance and keep their balance and their center of gravity right.
Yeah, or is it because they just haven't been challenged yet physically? I saw Team Germany earlier today play. Team Germany won earlier against Belgium.
Yeah.
And Team Germany was not the team that showed up yesterday. One of the huge adjustments they had made was they were skating much more obviously with their knees bent.
Yeah.
Because they were being knocked over left and right yesterday.
They were. I saw them take on Team France yesterday, took a big hit left, right, and center. Team France aren't a big team. There we go. It's another lead jammer for Team Wales now. Looks like Meredith. Everyone's favorite play, jammer on jammer action at the back. Meredith not taking any chances, just calls the jam. I'm not risking this one.
And that's still a smart play. There's just not enough points between the two teams to try to chance anything right now.
It's not worth risking it at all.
But it's been interesting to see Canadians more elusive jammers not being afraid to go head-to-head physically.
Speaking of physical, looks like Team Wales are going to throw the mechanic back into this one. He's a very physical jammer.
He's a very well-used jammer.
Yeah. You see, he just shoulder goes down and just head to the side. Works to great effect that time as he comes out first and takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
Now, as you take a look at Red on your screen, he is still totally jammed up. As look at this mechanic coming through. He's got the pivot to get by.
Oh, footwork again. You may have just missed it on screen. The mechanic was sideways skating backwards, held himself on track and round the pivot.
A tomahawk around the outside. Now we see we're going to see where the Canadian jammer is finally free. That is a huge Jam.
The mechanic with the last blocker on track. He dropped the shoulder and tried to charge into him. I couldn't see the name as to who it was. He just bounced off. And the Canadian blocker had a huge smile on his face. So proud of that one. Now this is what we like to see.
Actually, I think there's a little bit of confusion because there's so much red out there.
Yeah.
Do they realize that Walker's listening in?
I was going to say, I feel really sorry for Walker. They're having a team chat in at the back and Walker's just hovering around.
I don't
around.
Feel sorry for him. He knows what's coming up.
I feel sorry for him if they all turn around.
Yeah, yeah, that would be bad.
I think the mechanic just spotted it at the back and came in and went, excuse me.
Yeah, yeah.
Ashton showing the love with a slight stroke to Walker's panty.
That's
at the
a
top.
Nice helmet. Can I touch it?
I wish mine was black.
Your uniforms are so shiny. Ours are a little faded.
The thing is, you look at the back of some of the Team Wales shirts, you can see where they've clearly taken a heck of a beating.
Yeah.
I thought originally they were going for the rustic, rugged, you know, slightly worn out colours look. No, no, that's just the abuse they've taken this weekend.
Oh, look at that. Walker shoots out. Apparently he didn't like the helmet rubbing.
No, he says, I want to get away from you as quick as possible, and sets off like a rocket out of the blocks.
To hit Ashton, but... Oh, Ashton's got a battle up front. Ashton's going to get out there. Look at that.
Right through and takes lead this time, 2-8-2-8 for Team Wales.
Hey, this is a big deal, ladies and gentlemen. Team Wales putting up one heck of a fight. And you tell me that pack isn't like being in the middle of a trash compactor right about now.
Oh, whoa, nice footwork from Walker right at the end there. I believe they like to call that, I don't know how they say it in the States, but over here it's the creepy octopus.
Oh, really?
You spin round, transition round that last blocker, and turn again and you're off in the blink of an eye.
In the US, we've never given it that much thought.
No. We like to name things over here. Yeah, everything must have a name. Purely because we can't describe what you actually do, so we think we'll give it a name and yeah, we'll stick with that. Makes our jobs easier.
Eltonon going to take the line one more time. And you can see in the pack.
Team Wales started out with a spaced out four blockers there. And I'm not sure if that was intentional or if they just turned and saw Eltonon and went, no, I'm going nowhere near him.
And that was a nice job there by number 17. That's Jenkins, who skips the apex to get himself in position to block Eltonon. Unfortunately... You can't stop him, you can only contain him.
Elton On's actually been lucky. He started this one in a power jam situation as well. He's had, look, like, the footwork for someone of his size,
I know,
there
it's
is
incredible.
Insane.
Having familiarity with about a third of this roster, Eltonon is a skater I had never seen skate before, and he just blows me away.
He's so exciting to watch. He's like, his feet just never stop moving. He never gets caught standing still. He keeps going side to side, forward, back. He never stops.
Well, I think the thing that's really unusual, Eltonon, as we see him now approaching the pack as the Wales is going to try to speed it up, is that he is a jammer. He is not mixed in on the blocking rotation, at least not very often. So he is part of the jamming stable, but right there he's gonna get called for, I think, a track cut on the inside.
Yeah, Ashton's back in and jamming again now, 2-8-2-8 for Team Wales, and completes his initial pass through. Eltonon again sees Ashton coming back into the back of the pack, protects his own point, keeps a clean sheet and calls the jam off.
clean sheet, a soccer term.
Indeed, yeah.
A football term.
I'll go with soccer. I'll keep you covered for that one.
I got a son who's a goalie. Yeah.
I could never get past Waterboy. And even then, I wasn't very good, to be fair.
I played left out. Yeah. So we're going to see number F22. That's going to be Brad Ass.
Shoved his own blocker out of the way at the start of the jam there. Get out of my way. I want to get through.
Well, he's not the one that got through first. Oh, that's a pivot. Sorry. Ooh. He's been sent off for a penalty.
He is through first now. Phil, he gets there.
Yeah.
Take him a bit longer than normal, Brad Ass. He's normally through. 1 foot glide going backwards from the mechanic. 1 foot glides can be a nightmare at the best of times. Doing them going backwards and still keeping your balance, rotating around and skating off again is a talent to behold.
Well, the thing that amazes me about the mechanic, of course, like you said, his style is stylistically, I think the judges give him about a 4.
Yeah.
But as far as tenacity, strength, and getting low, makes a huge difference because he gets those big legs moving with that shoulder down, and it's like trying to stop. It's like trying to stop a running back.
Yeah, he's small, he's compact, he's powerful, and he uses what he's got to full effect.
And right there, you're going to see once again, that's going to be red. He comes out of your picture back in. And red right now caught in the midst. He's trying to work. There he goes. He's trying to work 17. That, of course, is Jenkins. He's able to move Jenkins out of the way.
Looks like a cut track now called on the Team Wales jam. Although Jones will now make his way to the sin bin.
And I tell you, this is too much fun. I'm so glad we've got two halves this time around.
Exactly, it's so much fun. I mean, so many of the UK-based teams, Team Wales, Team England.
Oh my!
Not impressed with the calls being made. Roll call just crashes into the back of the Team Canada wall.
And there's no call of any kind on the play.
I think, roll call's just smashing his way through the Team Canada defense.
Yeah.
Oh. Tries to swing his shoulder as he goes down.
And you know what? I mean, both you and I have to be honest at this point in saying that roll call is going to be very close to getting himself ejected.
He has to be careful and keep his emotions in check. He's getting very frustrated, very worked up. He can't let this get into his head.
Roll call being the only man to score points against Team USA, by the way. Or the first man to score points against Team USA.
Looks like he's not just getting frustrated, but what's going on track? He's charging through his own blockers, trying to get everyone riled up.
Well, and some of this starts to get to be a little flagrant, and that's not going to stand.
No, the referees... We work every bout with a minimum of 7 skating referees so that we've got eyes on everything to watch for all these sort of situations going on. Roll call's going to have to be careful. Keep his temper in check. He does not want to get himself ejected from a game like this.
No, and it'll be interesting. It'll be interesting to see if he's been pulled off the track by the Wales coach.
I think the sensible thing to do would be just to keep him off and give him a minute.
And let him get down to halftime and then...
Looks like he's back in again for this jam, though still pivoting. He may have a penalty outstanding against him waiting to serve his time.
I am incredibly surprised he didn't get called as he bulldozed the pack the last time. As we see right now, number 28, the one and only Ashton. And Ashton's going to put a couple of points up on the board. He's played incredibly, incredibly intelligently today.
Ashton has been probably Wales' standout jammer so far for this game. He's kept his cool. He doesn't get worked out. He's not the biggest of skaters. And coming up against a team like Canada, who are their strong, strong players.
Yeah. But what he has given them is lead jam. And that's not something they've gotten. I mean, right now, if we were to see the statistics, that would have to be heavily... I shouldn't say heavily, but it's definitely tipped in Canada's favor.
Definitely. But as you mentioned, although probably closely following Ashton would be Jones. He's been their next sort of most effective, although he served some time in the penalty box. When he's been on track, he's been effective.
Yeah, and Jones does just that. He gets Lee Jam. He's coming around. He's trying to put Folk.
Tried to take a whip off one of his own blockers there.
He's going to call it off. I think he's going to get a couple out of that. Are they going to give him goose eggs?
Nothing put up in the midst of it.
I think the one or two passes he had were out of bounds.
Yeah.
And they're funny about that.
I know. They don't let you score when you're not on track. I don't know why.
I don't know.
I'd be racking up power jams constantly if this was it, because I spend most of my time off track.
Yeah. Me too. It's safer there.
Be it on the floor, be it, you know, in the crowd. I'm really on the track, but there we go.
And we are off again. This time we are going to see.
It looks like F22 Bradass.
Yeah, that's
going
to be Bradass. And the jammer for Wales caught behind a nice two-wall up front.
But as
and
we've seen
they're going to be out of the zone of engagement.
As we've seen earlier, he's out on his own, but it's the mechanic. Again, the shoulder goes down, the stance gets lower, and he just, bang, powers through.
Yeah, he is the toolbox. And I'll tell you, but we take a look at this Smack Daddy, and, you know, right now it's... Oh, wait. I'm sorry. We're going to get one more jam off here.
Yeah.
Or a couple jams off here.
I think we've still got time left. There's about 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes or so left.
Must be the lighting in here, because I know it's not my age that I can't read the time from over there.
It's just me. I don't wear a watch because I just can't tell time. I'm just looking at numbers and saying 2:30.
And this time around, we're going to see Meredith out there jamming for Wales. That'll be his first time out on the track. And he's going to be your lead jammer.
Takes lead, bit of confusion from the Team Canada blockers. They thought they'd forced him off. He kept himself on track.
As we see Red finally break through. I think Meredith wants to come back in and see if he can't get a few more, but he's going to have to call it off. He sees Red coming around the corner.
Meredith just does the sensible thing again. Couple of points on the board. Don't risk it. With more time available in these games, there's no point in risking anything at all. Save your energy.
And, you know, the great thing about this is Wales is not playing to say, oh, you know, we only lost by 100 points. They're playing because they want this.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they managed to rack up 13 points, I think we said, against Team USA. Yesterday, in just a half-hour scenario, they've already managed to just about double that coming up against Team Canada this time. In the same amount of time, you can show how much they've improved, because between Team Canada and Team USA, they are two of the strong favorites for this tournament.
Absolutely.
Overall. Very similar style. I mean, they've all received the same, you know, sort of time training. Oh, we've got a flag in the lap of the track in here. You can't see it on your live feed, but we've got a Team Canada fan with a flag riling the crowd up, be it Team Canada fans or otherwise.
Absolutely naked.
Yeah.
I made that part up.
No, you didn't. That's why it wasn't on the screen.
No, I made that part up. As you can see before, they're challenging a call. In the center of the track, you saw Titchborn out there. Coach Lime is out there, as well as the Wales crew. We're not exactly sure what it is they're challenging. Uh-oh.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, he did take his shirt off.
The
that he didn't
gone.
Do before.
Oh, hang on. Now we've got it off.
Uh-oh.
Oh, see what you like about what goes on track. There is never a better atmosphere than when the fans just start going crazy.
And that would be your halftime show.
Yeah. Someone forgot to tell them we're not quite there yet.
Yeah,
that last whistle was for a time.
God knows I wouldn't give them another 10 minutes.
No. 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 No.
We'd,
no.
You'd have to order that off of Vimeo.
I was going
to
say, that would be a pay-per-view you're paying for that
one.
Oh, dear. Just goes to show the difference that you get with a roller derby crowd compared to any other live sporting event you see anywhere.
Yeah, because we all know that if that happened in another sport, it'd be some dude with a sponsor.
Yeah. Not just that, you'd have security on them in the blink of an eye saying, get out of here, what are you doing? We come to this and we know that roller derby as a whole knows you're going to get fans out there trying to work everyone else up into a frenzy. They're not doing anything negative by it. They're not aggravating anyone else.
They're having a good time. And once again, we can't really express enough the flavor that you get when you go to an international event like the World Cup, like the first Women's World Cup, like any European tournament.
Yeah.
I was at Ghent last year. It didn't matter. These were not world teams. These were league teams. However, the people that came and represented, the cheers, the horns, the level of excitement in a relatively modest venue, it was deafening. It was absolutely deafening.
Yeah. Just to mention for that, actually, as we said earlier, a lot of the Team Wales skaters actually take part for one particular league, SWS, down in South Wales. And they entered into their first sort of massive European competition last year at the MERDC and finished seventh in their first tournament. I mean, these guys are, they don't see each other regularly. They skate together regularly, but socially, I don't think they see each other a lot.
No.
But they've managed to come in, and as part of a European tournament for their league, they finished seventh. They're now all here taking part in an international tournament, in a World Cup for Team Wales. And the effort that they put in, it's just incredible.
Yeah. Yep. No, very. This has been a very fun one to watch. And as long as we're on a timeout, let's say thank you to Green Monster Roller Sports. All new. Visit us today. That's Green Monster, GRNMNSTR.com.
I think they've managed to sort out whatever it was they were doing during that official timeout. They're now ready to go. Ashton in now jamming again for Team Wales.
That's going to be Walker out there for Canada. They had Walker pretty well contained. He was able to find a crease in the front wall. He gets through. And in the meantime,
I think he went past the Team Wales wall like they weren't even there. I never saw him slow down.
I didn't see it either.
I didn't see him slow down. He entered the back of the pack at one speed, came out the same speed at the other side. Comes the man-beast
Elton. And of course, one of the interesting things about Team Canada is they have not played other world teams. Mm-hmm. So they come in here, nobody for a moment thinking that they're not going to be strong, but nobody really knowing how they stack up, or better yet, who the players are. Yeah. As we're going to see Elton on take lead jam and go around the corner, we see a helmet panty tossed off the track, and apparently that was just a matter of getting rid of it before the play started. Oh, Elton on, look at that, he's going to spin all the way backwards out of a block.
This man amazes me on track. He really does. I cannot sing his praises enough from a personal standpoint.
Right there, a little skip step.
Leaves me breathless. We've had a message through on Twitter now from Ali Bunn. He wants to see what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object. I think he's talking about the mechanic as a jammer for Team Wales.
And you know what?
90% of the
You're going to get that, my friend.
We'll get to see more of that in the second half as the first half comes to an end. Now, we're going to flip over to some adverts, I think, now during the halftime.
I think so. But let's just take a moment and talk about this game. And that is that, Team Canada has done such a nice job all this entire tournament. Team Wales has made this an exciting game. The score doesn't even matter at this point. Got to watch it jam by jam. This is Bob Noxious for the one and only Smack Daddy. We're going to send you to some advertising. Come back and see us in about 20. Power Jam! Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen, welcome back. This is Bob Noxious from Madison, Wisconsin, USA with the Brew City Bruisers. Well, of course, the Brew City Bruisers aren't out here. I'm sitting alongside the one, the only Smack Daddy.
Good job. There's only one. More than one of me would be a danger. It wouldn't work out too well, I don't think.
Go ahead and you know, pimp your league here.
I do. The Granite City Roller Girls are a team I referee for back up in Aberdeen. And the Granite City Brawlermen, a massive shout out to them. Newly formed, only been going for a handful of months now. We've got some fantastic skaters involved. And a couple of which are down here representing Team Scotland this week as well. So
awesome. Very good.
Extremely excited to see them on track later today, taking on Team USA, I believe. That could be interesting.
Yeah, Team USA really, really making a run at people. Of course, the true test is yet to come, probably later today and, of course, tomorrow. They will actually award it's either four or five different trophies.
Yep.
Of course, the big trophy being a nice pewter trophy with Apex Alex.
Apex Rex.
Oh, Apex Rex. I'm sorry.
The Spirit of Derby Cup, I think they've called it.
Yes, you're right. Didn't have the cheat sheet this time. Yeah. Took a guess, and as usual, I was wrong.
Someone stole our equipment. They're trying to make this more challenging for us.
That's right. And I tell you, the mechanic came over here, and he was curious as to what people were seeing at home, and we said, well, we might have talked about you a few times. But here's a shout out to his family. He says, Sarah, Dylan, Saren, and Larry, Daddy misses you and we'll see you when he gets home. And we wanted to make sure that was in an American accent because I'm sure it sounds nothing like the way it's normally pronounced.
It's a lot better than hearing it in a Scottish accent, I'll say that much. It came through a lot clearer. One thing that you'll probably pick up as well is the noise being made once again at the start of the second half.
Ladies and gentlemen, the only way to explain this is to say that it has been a heavyweight bout in which I can't say that you could concede any winner. It's just that round by round, Canada has come out just a little bit ahead. And that was a much better analogy than I can normally come up with.
Team Canada took full effect of a few power jams they had available to them in the first half as well. Managing to put a few points on the board. It stands currently at the end of the first half, and before we start the next one, Canada 116, Wales 25.
It was interesting during the halftime. I saw some of the blockers skating around and talking to each other a little bit, and maybe just trying to cool heads a little bit as we saw things were getting pretty intense toward the end.
Yeah, roll call, I believe, especially for Team Wales, was getting just a little bit heated.
Yeah, and there goes Tanan.
Picking up where he left off in the first half, just so quick on his feet, he's through and takes the lead again for Team Canada.
That's right, and if you are just tuning in, of course, Canada in the red and black. Wales in the slightly less red and black.
Slightly less red, but
A different color of red, I should say. Sorry. The Canadians more in the black color.
Yeah, a nice red strip right down the side of their strips. I'm going to say all of the team's equipment and outfits for this tournament have been pretty awesome.
Yeah. We've seen no duct tape numbers. No Sharpie names.
I'm just going to say no Sharpie numbers on the arms either, I don't think.
Yeah. And as you can see right now, this is what we've been looking at the entire first period. It has been like a trash compactor. And I tell you, the jammers, as they go through, if this was a blender, they went from chop to puree in a hurry.
In an instant. One button press, they're gone.
And, oh, look at the speed. Was that Walker?
Bradass, I think
Bradass.
That was. Some of these Team Canada skaters are just so quick.
On the feed, he was actually pixelated.
He went from Bradass to the Flash in the blink of an eye.
Exactly. Now we're going to see red. The rotation has been about four different jammers, and that has been Bradass, red, Tanan, and
Walker, I think.
Walker, yes, thank you.
It's been good. It's been working to full effect for Team Canada, though, keeping their jammers fresh.
Well, I think it's actually one of the biggest advantages that they've had over Wales.
The Wales' most effective jammer in the first half has been Ashton, who's out now again,
yes,
and takes lead jammer for this one.
And lead jam being one of the keys that Canada has capitalized on.
Unfortunately for Ashton, he did take lead, but then commits a back block as he comes into the back of the Team Canada pack and now has to take a seat in the sin bin, giving advantage back to Red and Team Canada.
And that's something the coach has really got to talk to them about, because they have given up way too many penalties. This should be a very tight game, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, granted, it's 100 points apart with 30 minutes to go, and we've seen crazier things. And jam by jam, this is as much fun as we have seen all weekend. But we have just seen too many penalties where we've got the Wales jammer coming in much too hot into the pack and getting themselves into trouble.
Yeah, I think Ashton and the mechanic especially have just been too fired up. They need to just put the brakes on that little bit quicker as they come into the back of the pack, slow themselves down.
Yep.
Too many back blocks have been committed, and it's just cost them many points.
Where we've seen Jones actually come in, take what he's got, and call it off, playing it a little more smartly. But it's getting to the point where this chipping away is going to get out of reach.
Yeah.
If they don't start to pull more lead jams and start to control what they're getting from the Canadian jammers.
Ashton now back in play again. Phil takes a big hit right in the back of the pack. It puts him down. He's forced off, recycled to the back, but the jam comes to an end.
And we see Coach Lime right out there right now. Next to him is Titchborne, who you may know as Noah Backtalk.
We've had a message through on Twitter now, excuse me, from Pick Hunt Chu, saying Wales versus Canada, my ovaries can't take it. That's got to go down as the most interesting tweet I've had to read out so far.
We just only hope that came from a woman.
Yeah, I was going to say, that doesn't specify male or female.
No.
We'll go with female. My ovaries can't take it.
Yeah, mine can't either as we watch this next jam. Oh, look at this pack.
Strong block off recycles the Team Canada jammer all the way to the back, whereas at the front, situation, it looks like.
Is that Ashton that's going to get sent all the way back to the...
I think it's Meredith jamming for Team Wales.
Yeah, you're right. I should trust you.
No one ever does.
Yeah, I know.
I've got one of those faces.
I got the same problem. And Meredith, he almost keeps it in bounds as he's coming through turn number four. And
unfortunately, he just came back onto track too early. He misjudged which blocker it was, and it forced him off and stepped back in ahead of
small mistakes.
Looks like we've got fluster jamming now for the first time in this bout, I think, for Team Canada. He's having to work hard at the back of the pack. He's being held back now by Team Wales.
I was held back for 2 grades.
I was held back for 2 years at school.
And there we're going to see no call in the rev, shaking it up a little bit.
Another strong block. Roll call forces Fluster off track, puts him back.
That was a roll call. That time it was number 117.
That was roll call.
And roll call right there, again, sometimes you got a question of frustration. Why would he cut through the inside of the track to get to the back?
Yeah. Strange decision to do, to be fair, and it cost them.
There are two things that are very important about athletics. One is your ability, but we all know that if you've played any kind of sport, mental focus and ability to play with discipline is by far as important.
Mental discipline is one of the things that costs me when it comes to playing games like this. I don't have the concentration that these guys do.
And I tell you, Canada has played so incredibly smartly.
Eltonon just bounces off the final block, slides down the last one on one knee, essentially, on the floor, and takes lead for Canada.
And if you didn't watch the first half, Eltonon is not a blocker jamming. He is part of a four-man rotation.
He is a jammer first and foremost before anything else.
Eltonon, obviously a guy that as the weekend progresses we really need to talk to, because it'd be very interesting to find out how he developed into that position.
He's not someone that you look at and initially think is a jammer. He does not, you know, people have this sort of idea in their head that jammers are the smaller skaters in the team. They're small.
Oh! Tomahawk around the outside with a spin! And a triple sow cow!
And that is why he's a jammer. This is what people don't think a man of his size is capable of doing, yet he does it!
Oh, no! He falls to the inside! But still, how spectacular was that? Nick Walenda would be proud of that one.
That's just awesome. It looks like we've now got a similar situation going on with Meredith, though. I think he's cut track on the outside, and now I'm seeing.
Yeah, but Meredith has got to get his butt moving. If his time's not going to start till he sits down.
And the problem is, the longer it takes for him to sit down, Eltonon serving that time, he now has to serve the same amount of time that Tanon did. He's cost himself valuable seconds in the sin bin.
Oh, look at that. Roll call's going to catch up with Eltonon down in the first turn. Run him to the inside. Eltonon comes back out and then takes it out on Creighton Griffiths. Ladies and gentlemen, seriously, at some point in time, if the score just is not close, don't worry about watching it. Watch this thing jam for jam, and this is as much fun as we have seen all weekend long.
It's been fantastic. You mentioned Clayton there just putting in that block on Eltonon at the end. As he came off track at the end of the jam, a huge smile on his face that he came away with something like that. You talk about interesting things, we've had a true derby fact sent to us via Twitter. Apparently, Fluster Cluck from Canada has a part-time ninja as a roommate, complete with a ninja training room. That's any chance they know the rest of Team Japan? They're known as Ninjapan, which is quite interesting.
Oh, like that's that uncommon, really.
I'm confused.
Who has not had a ninja roommate at
I'm
some
I'm concerned
point.
As to why he's only a part-time ninja. Yeah. Surely that's something that requires full-time commitment.
Yeah, it seems like a more dedicated type of thing.
Does part-time ninja mean you can only see him sometimes? I'm not entirely sure where that comes from.
Oh, my apologies.
I know, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, don't apologize. That the insights of the one, the only Mr. Smack Daddy. As we take a look, as we have this official timeout, we want to thank the Quad Skate Shop, who is sponsoring the penalty box on this track, Europe's original brick and mortar roller derby equipment supplier. Quad Roller Skate Shop has the best selection and most stock of any store on the continent. With excellent consultation services that only a fellow skater could provide, we've got all your needs covered. We love this game.
They're not the only ones. We've got tons of people loving the game of roller derby nowadays. It's the fastest growing sport in the world.
No, it is not.
It is in Europe. I'll narrow it down to Europe.
Oddly enough, and here for all of you back at home, the fastest growing sport in the world is an actual, real, converted version from the Harry Potter books of Quidditch.
Quidditch, yes. I forgot they'd taken over. Still in Europe. We haven't adopted Quidditch as much in Europe yet.
Yeah, but don't run around with a broom between their legs.
We have a distinct lack of brooms over here. I don't know why.
No, it's okay. Don't do it.
We've had a halftime score passed to us from the other game going on the Quad Skate Shop track. England currently 217 to Australia 60.
I wouldn't have expected that. I didn't expect that.
I thought Australia would have put in a bigger score than that in the first half, but England currently in the lead, a convincing lead so far. Let's see what Australia can do in the second half. As on track just now, we see the mechanic doing what he can to help Wales along and takes lead jammer in this one.
Oh, and a nice duck as he goes through the back stretch, comes through backwards. He's going to pick up, is it 2 points? But he's going to go on a 2-0 run. And if you saw that at home, you didn't see much. He kind of disappeared, came back up out of that. And right now I have a feeling Sarah and the kids are pretty excited.
I think they're all feeling pretty proud of them at home right now. Oh, now that was interesting. Star pass over the top of the wall. He can take lead jammer, but instantly passes the panty across the top and completes the star pass in the blink of an eye.
And that's so important because most of the time it is such a slow, meticulous process that everybody in the crowd is kind of like, star pass.
Yes. And they've done that about 4 times before it's completed.
Okay, we got a little information passed to us here about that last official timeout. The track cut that was called was argued to have been a no pass, no point. Call stands.
Joys of the referees, their decision's final. Looks like jamming for the first time in this one for Team Wales. We've got 117 roll call. He's pivoted and blocked for Team Wales so far to pretty good effect, we'll say. Elton on was the one who's forced him off, and he just recycles him almost back round to the front of the opposition pack.
And they're still going to call him. No, they're going to call him for skating out of bounds. That's because he did the right thing. He went down to his knees, but he thought when he got to the center, he was safe. Well, you're out of bounds in the center, too.
Unfortunate for him. I've just been passed a note telling me it's confirmed. Fluster Clock is actually part-time ninja, part-time repairman.
Oh, okay. So he doesn't have a roommate.
It looks like it's him. Him or a roommate is part-time repairman instead.
Okay.
It's an interesting job combination, but there we go. Yeah.
Shows up at your house, you don't even know what job's done.
Exactly.
Bill's sitting on a table.
In, out, and you thought it was a shadow just walking through. No. Turns out it was your repair guy.
We got to remember to watch him at the after party. I don't want to make him mad.
I'm sure he'd get on really well with a mechanic. It looks like on your live feed, the clock has unfortunately stopped. I don't think they've had an update on the score through the clock or the score either, unfortunately. You see the score on your screens. No, it's got back up and running now. We're 184 to Canada, Team Wales on 29 with just under 17 and a half minutes left to go.
And as we watch here, trying to see who that was. It looked like it might have been...
I think it was number 9-11.
Was that Tetchborn that had him held up? No, that's...
9-11, Homer Jensey, I think he was...
Not a name that we've called a lot so far today. And of course, you know, anytime we say something like this, and I'm dead serious, there are so many great plays that go on. Everything moves so fast with the angles, sometimes we just don't always see them.
You can't always keep up to date with everything that goes on the track, even with two of us standing here.
Here's a Twitter read. Physics, the fastest way to the ground is to show red your sternum. Now, that's a great quote. I don't know why it took you about 45 minutes to come up with it.
I'd have said the fastest way to the hospital, perhaps, is to show red your sternum. Maybe not to the ground, because I'm not sure you'd know.
We saw that a little bit earlier in the first half, where one of the Wales blockers put about 3-4 foot of space between he and red. Upon which Red dropped his shoulder and dropped him like a 3-foot putt.
When someone tries that, there are 3 hits. Red hits you, you hit the ground, and the ambulance hits 90.
Yeah, exactly. And that is kilometers, people.
Yeah.
And it looks like we've got another timeout right now. I tell you what, let's say thank you to the GBEMS. That would be the Great Britain Emergency Medical Service, would be my guess. The next jam brought to you by GBEMS, the only UK RDA endorsed medical team. And of course, we love the people at Green Monster Roller Sport. Represented once again here at the Men's World Cup.
Indeed. We thank Green Monster for all their help so far. You can go to their website, I think. Is it grnmnstr.com?
You are good. You are good.
It's one of those take away the vowels.
Yeah. Very, Vanna, show me a vowel.
I know. Write down the words Green Monster.
Well, I see. I grew up in Milwaukee, so I'm really used to names that don't have vowels.
Whereas you go to Wales, and they've got names that involve more vowels than anything
consonants?
Else. 72 letters in one word, and about two of them are consonants if you're lucky with some of them.
Wow.
It's crazy.
And we're going to see Bradis out there once again. And he will be up against number 254, which is going to be Jones. Jones has had a pretty good day.
Nice little jump across two Team Canada blockers there. They were, skates were together, their shoulders weren't, and Jones just hopped over the skates through the middle.
I would say, you know, the one thing you can say about Jones is he's been very efficient. He gets lead jam, which has been a big problem for Wales, and then he puts up a handful of points. At this point, he doesn't put the points up. But he gives him the opportunity.
Yeah, the interesting thing with Jones as well, he's a very knowledgeable guy. He's actually a referee and has been a tournament head referee throughout the UK as well. He was a tournament head referee at a tournament in Swansea a few months ago with Quad Nations. It was hosted. Teams from all corners of the UK went down and competed, and he was very effective. Not only can he skate men's derby, but he's a great referee as well.
And it looks like we've got an update on one of the players.
I think it's Hayes from Team Wales has actually been expelled now for a slide tackle.
And that was something that we were concerned about earlier. Not necessarily from Hayes in particular, but we were starting to see a little frustration build up. And once again, there we see number 79. That's going to be the mechanic once again. I don't think... Nope, looks like everything was fine on that. But again, still coming in awfully hot. I think the only thing that saves him on that one is he calls off the jam before the contact.
I'm not entirely sure he was a success. I think he may have actually been called on a penalty at the end.
He did.
He's taking his seat now in the sin bin. Unfortunately, we'll start with a power jam for Team Canada, and it's red on track for them. Team Canada fact, Greg Gustav lives 500 kilometers from his home team.
Wow.
That is one heck of a distance he has to travel to skate for them. Doesn't look like it affects him too much, though, as he skates around and takes lead jammer for Canada. Maybe he skates that 500 kilometers to his team. That's where he gets to practice.
Oh, nice cutback to the inside. And he's going to get around Jenkins. Jenkins, one of those arms moving, I almost thought was going to catch him.
Just about.
Right upside the head.
Red's too quick to get caught. Luckily for Jenkins, Red was just too quick across and managed to avoid the arm flailing.
Yeah, not something that was done purposefully, but very close.
Power block at the front. I think that was Tank there just decked one of the Team Wales blockers.
And again, you have to go back to Canada and you have to take a look at their fundamentals. You don't knock them over. They're so well leveraged. Their footwork, their team play, I just can't say enough about it. I'm incredibly impressed.
Extremely positive for them. And I got to say, I think, although we haven't spoke about him much during this one, the standout blocker for me for Team Canada has been Tank. He's just so effective at that front position.
Yes.
You don't talk about him much, but you don't need to. He lets all his talking done for him on the track. And you can see for yourselves how effective he's been as that last blocker for Team Canada. He just holds the position and no one gets through him.
Well, I think part of the reason he's been so successful is Wales does not have that jammer with that quick step like we're seeing out of the Canadians.
Yeah.
They're not going to be able to juke him nearly as easily as Walker's going to be able to do as he's out there. And there we see Brad Ass. Oh, nice move. That was the Malachi crunch right there. He's stuck between two of the Wales players. He's going to get himself through. And he's going to call that jam off. And the score now starting to show itself at 210 to 29. Nonetheless, the most enjoyable bout I think I've watched this weekend. And I've seen some that with a much closer score.
It's been a fantastic game to watch so far. Some big hits, but some strong skating from both teams as well. Team Wales do have quite a few supporters at home watching the live feed this weekend. A shout out to some of their rink rats, as they're known, She Dog and Skatey Perry from New Wales Roller Derby.
And of course, Team Canada just has so much depth. We have to acknowledge the fact that that has got to be playing a big part of it right now.
They've got a very, very strong overall roster. There's no one you could look at within the Team Canada roster and think, you know, consider what some people would call a weak link.
No,
there is no weak link throughout their team. There's no one you'd consider to be overly penalty heavy. There's no one who's not a great technical skater. There's no one who can't put in and take a hit out.
As we see Tanan out there one more time, doing what he does best, picking up lead jammer and then just finding his way through blockers. A man that large should not be that agile.
We talked about defying the laws of physics earlier. I think that man does it all by himself.
Yeah. I've watched a lot of men's derby in the US, a lot of MRDA top derby. And I don't know that I have seen a big man like that can move that way.
We've got some big guys who skate throughout the whole of Scotland, but none who have the same just overall ability that Elton On seems to have.
And this Twitter, we got a tweet here saying, thanks to the feed announcers for all the love being showered on the Ottawa Derby cast. Well, we're showering a lot of love on both teams. It's just that the Canadian team is obviously the one that is the better team at this moment. And we have to be honest in saying the sport is that much more developed than the country as well.
Definitely.
And you're talking to Bob Noxious, who would be in Canada anytime that he could. So
I've had the joys of meeting a lot of the Team Wales skaters. I mean, I've skated down in Wales myself. I've announced things down in Wales. And the guys themselves in their team are a fantastic group of people. I've met Jones personally several times. I've spoke to the mechanic a few times. And they're a fantastic group of guys.
Yeah.
They really are an absolutely fantastic group of guys. And they're the first ones to admit themselves whether or not they're at the level that some of the other teams here may be. But what I love about Team Wales is they don't let that get to them. They don't go on track. They're similar to, you know, some of the other teams we've seen this weekend. They'll see teams out there and go, they've got better skaters than us. But we're not going to let that affect us in the slightest. We're going to go out and do what we do best. We'll play to our strengths. And again, as we mentioned earlier, they've managed to score more points against Team Canada than they did against Team USA yesterday. In the space of a day, they've more than doubled their progress against teams of similar standards.
Yeah, and the truth of the matter is they're playing a much better game than I would say the lower half of what we've lower half of the teams that we've seen. And there they're going to get a power jam.
Looks like number 16.
That's Mardi Gras, who we've not seen jam more than maybe one other time this game.
And one of Wales' most effective jammers for this game, the mechanic, in a situation that he's going to love. He's going to come up to the back of that Team Canada wall and just push. Push, step shallow water, push his way through and just force them forward.
Well, this also begs to ask the question, is Canada now going to start fielding some of the other players, protecting players like Walker, like Bradass, like Tanon?
Yeah, connect them, but again, credit to the mechanic there. Great footwork as he just steps around the inside. He skates round, and as he reaches each turn, he looks to be tiring so much, but it just doesn't seem to slow him down.
Oh, and right there, look at it. As you see on your screen, talk about a battle with a three wall. He's got Bradass, the ref,
as casual as you can get for a call off. This isn't working.
And then the ref coming up and giving him a tap. Now, if you know the ref, that's exactly how that guy is.
He just looked at him and said, there you go.
Yeah, like, where are you going to go, dude? That was hilarious. So then they both tapped each other on the shoulder and had a laugh about it. The rep, of course, being the coach that initially got Montreal's News Kids up into the WFTDA Top 40.
Oh, there's Jones now starting off in a power jam situation for Team Wales. Works the crowd up as he goes round the outside. Big cheer to them and takes lead for Team Wales.
I'm surprised we haven't seen Jones out there a little bit more often. Unless,
big hit takes Mardi Gras out to the side. Mainwaring with a massive smash, but looks like he's going to get the benefit of a power jam now. Jones on his way to the sin bin for a cut track round the outside.
He must have just clipped it. From our point of view, it didn't look. We didn't even see it.
This will be a chance for Mardi Gras to show us what he can do as he jams once again for Team Canada.
Well, Mardi Gras, the scenario where Team Canada is going to let him try to fight for himself. Now you're going to see blockers step in, and they're going to have to. Mardi Gras does not have the leg strength to push through the wall that Wales is going to put up.
Looks like he's doing the sensible thing, realized he wasn't too effective. Quick star pass now as he hands it over to his pivot and allows him to work his way through. It looks like that's Walker making rounds. If you're going to have a pivot to pass the panty to, Walker's not one you'd be worried about passing it to.
Well, and that's why we've seen so many of the jammers playing that position, because really the pivot position is all about that right now.
It's all about strength for it. We've had a message from Roadkill Device saying, is it me or is Team Canada fielding Walker?
I'm sorry, that's Roadkill DeVille.
DeVille, I apologize. It's the handwriting of those who hand the notes to me. It's not
I know.
He's asking if Team Canada field their shortest blockers while Tanon jams. No, he just makes them look that
exactly
small. They're not really short. It's just the size of Tanon when he jams.
Oh, and we're going to see El Tanon's going to get sent off.
The Jones came back in, put a five-point grand slam on the board before the jam could end.
And, of course, we want to remind you that if you enjoy listening to this, drop us a few quid, dollars, lira, whatever it is that you spend, using the link on broadcast page. That money is split 50-50 between covering the broadcast and the team's travel funds.
Looks like, again, we've got a bit of a pause, I think, on the time and score on the live feed. Now, to give you an update, there's around 5 minutes left to go in this second half. Canada currently stand 238 to Wales 41, not the 29 we thought they're up to.
I mean, I can tell you right now that if Smack Daddy and I weren't sitting here, we'd be sitting at his place, you know, having a party.
Definitely.
And if you're doing that right now, we want you to look us up on Instagram under MRDWC. Share your photos of yourself enjoying the cup wherever you are, and maybe you'll make it onto the stream.
You just never know. I know I've been abusing the hashtag MRDWC on Instagram so far. I got quite a lot of people up on there.
To know you, my friend, if that's the worst thing,
the worst thing I can do, you'd never know.
Yeah.
I got a fantastic one of myself and Rogue Runner from London Brawling earlier today,
which I am
extremely proud of, one of my skating idols. The crowd now going absolutely crazy as once again during an official timeout we have one from Team Canada, one from Team Wales out with their team flags, two from Wales overpowering them, getting this crowd so worked up. Ironically, she's running around with a Team Wales flag, wearing a Team Finland t-shirt by the looks of things.
And of course, you've been watching all of this action from the Roller Derby City track. This jam and every jam has been brought to you by Roller Derby City. We are so thankful for your support. Without the support of sponsors like Roller Derby City and Squad Skate Shop, who knows if things like this are even able to happen. Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of roller derby kits and merchandise.
A special mention to Roller Derby City as well, as they helped out one of Team Ninjapan's skaters at the start of this tournament. When he came over here, his skates had been damaged.
Oh, I heard about that.
They were damaged beyond repair. They weren't sure he was going to be able to skate. Roller Derby City donated a pair of skates to the guy who had traveled so far here to make sure he could take part in the World Cup. A fantastic sort of show of derby love, shall we say, from Roller Derby City to the tournament. We're really appreciative to them.
And we also want to thank Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007. That's www.fastgirlskates.com.
I like the way you ended that, .com. It's just the tail off. You're so professional. I love this, Bob.
I tell you, you know, and I got to tell you what, for all of you that are out in Canada listening, this is Bob Noxious. I want you to know that this weekend is the year. This marks 1 year my ban from Canada has ended as of this weekend. And I will see you, I'll see y'all in Montreal.
Hey, that rhymes.
Next month as we get this thing rolling. And yeah, it's going to be mechanic out there once again.
Starting off with a power jam by the looks of things now for Team Wales. Makes it through the last blocker, just skips around the outside of the tank and takes lead jammer.
Oh! You guys had a great angle to see that move. It started out as a tomahawk, and then he leans into 1 foot, almost made it through.
Oh, the tank seems to have it in for the mechanic just now. He does not want to let him pass. These two have a fantastic rivalry through this game.
And Titchborne out there as well in the pivot helmet helping. And guess who's back out on the track? Coming out of the roller derby. I'm sorry, out of the quad skate shop penalty box.
Looks like just a clarification of what we had there. The red jammer, Team Wales blocked Team Canada's blocker out of play. The Team Canada blocker was just defending himself, but nothing was called.
Gotcha. You know, it's interesting because when they have these replays, they get together and they look at one ref who is sweating bullets.
Yeah.
And they're saying, rewind your mind. And think. No pressure.
Nope, nothing at all. This does not depend on one skater staying on track. Don't risk it. This isn't a big international World Cup.
No, it's not a big thing. Don't worry about it. As we see the action back once again, we're going to see, Jones?
I think it's Ashton now going for Team Wales.
I believe you're right, actually. That's Ashton out there right now, as well as...
Stand aside jamming for Team Canada.
Stand aside, of course. Speed skating legend.
A 51-year-old speed skating legend. Goes to show that age isn't a thing.
Not if you keep yourself in shape and put the right stuff in your body.
Oh. And that, I mean, shrugging off a block while skating backwards. How?
Yeah, and, you know, and I've met Stand Aside before. That was not him showing off. That was just him saying, okay, I'm through. Now I can turn back around.
Yeah. He does it all with a smile on his face and a song in his heart. It doesn't...
Depth.
I know. This is a man who has been blocking like his life depended on it throughout this entire game. Comes into jam for the first time in this bout, with the exception of the star pass that we saw earlier on.
Yep.
And again, just effortless, seamless.
Well, and the important thing about any team, and Team Canada doing a very good job with this, is regardless of how many jams you are going to play, you have a job to do. As a former coach, I would always say, you know, it doesn't matter if you're going to jam six, if you're going to be out there for six jams, you're going to be out there for 18 jams. You need, you know, we're only going to win if everybody does what it is they need to do, regardless of how many times or how few times you're going to do it.
Yep.
Team Canada has been doing that all weekend long so far.
Looks like the ref now, I think, has gone for a direction of gameplay call there as he takes a seat in the bin, joined by Homer, 9-11. Homer Jensey, sorry. Bradass back out doing what he does best. Again, just around the inside line, jamming again. Ashton trying his hardest.
Well, I'll tell you, he and Walker are almost interchangeable in their styles.
Cut track called on Ashton there as he was forced off track.
And I tell you, lots of really good sportsmanship. When men's derby got started early, sometimes the testosterone flared up a little bit. I tell you, we've seen nothing like that.
No.
Here. Nothing at all.
There's been a lot of calm skating. I mean, people get caught up in the heat of the moment. Things get agitated, but it never lasts.
No.
It never lasts.
Nope.
The guys are calm enough. They go, actually, you know something? No, we're here to play. Let's play.
Yep. It's been nothing but respect. And we have to respect what he's doing out there right now. That's Fluster himself.
Never gets flustered, though, does he? Keeps his head down and just carries on with the job in hand.
And, you know, and the thing is, with as good as he is jamming, we've only seen him jam maybe three or four times.
Exactly. But to see him jam, you'd think he was a natural. You'd think he did it all the time.
I would think he was half ninja.
Looks like a Scot, yeah.
And at this point, we are on the jam clock, ladies and gentlemen. And as we see this thing start to wind down, we want to thank the MRDA, of course. Men's Roller Derby Association wants to wish all the teams in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck. MRDA is the national governing body for men's flat track roller derby. For more information, you want to contact them, go ahead and see the website, Men's Roller Derby Association.com.
Well, final whistle's gone for this one now as we wait to get confirmation of the final score. We're going to have a quick recap
and
of what we saw during that game, and wow.
Yeah, again, it comes down, I think it's going to come down to, it simply comes down to bench strength, experience, but I tell you, the next time we see Wales, it's going to be really, really exciting.
Well,
European Derby, people, if you've not seen it, women's or men's, is just amazingly exciting. We're going to have the Women's World coming up in Dallas. It's going to be fantastic. And I tell you with that, this is Bob Knox as I am sitting next to my new best friend, Smack Daddy, and we are going to sign off and say, hope you're enjoying the coverage.
Hi there, you've just been on the Roller Derby City track watching Team Wales versus Team Canada. I think Canada has some of the best fans of the tournament at the moment. I think they shipped the whole of Ottawa here. I'm here today because you might have missed some of the action earlier on over on the Quad Skate Shop track, where we had the unfortunate situation of an early-ended game because Team Argentina actually had too many players foul out to be able to fulfill their penalty requirements. If you missed that, what we've got here is Captain Malis, who was our announcer, who had a bit of an emotional time over on that track. Malis, can you just talk us through what got us to you to that emotional point and what basically the feeling was on that track during those last moments of that game?
Okay, so Argentina lined up with 8 skaters at the start of the game, and they kept 8 skaters to the halfway point. During halftime, I'm checking the Twitter feeds, and I got our Spanish language announcer to translate one from Argentina, where the 8 skaters referred to as the 8 gladiators. And I was like, okay, I have to get the one out there. So I did that. And then as the second half wore on, the penalties came through thick and fast, and Argentina had one, then a second, and a third player foul out. They were down to what we referred to as Iron Man Derby. Basically, all 5 skaters were the 5 skaters on there. And then Optimus Quad, who's the Argentina captain, he fouled, and he was on 6. And you know he knew. He knew straight away. He skated around the track. There was tears streaming down his eyes. And he's applauding the fans. And the fans were cheering back at him. And he sat down and the jam ended. And he was instructed to leave the box and escorted past the announcer desk, past myself and King Crazy. And as he passed us, tears again streaming down his face. Braveheart, Big Jim, and a third team front skater were watching and bounded down from the stands and just took him into their arms and embraced him and just cheered. They basically just held him there as he cried. And I was looking across, and it's that moment where you see where Derby is a community, not bound by nations, it's a global community. We are all here together. And that moment is a pure spirit of Derby moment, and that's what we're here for in the Cup. And that just tore a little piece out of me right here. And I'm there, tears coming down my face on the feed, trying to keep professional. And that's what's going on, as the crowd then lines the entire track. But more of them want to be there. So they tunnel the entire, where both of them are there with making a tunnel. And Argentina take two laps through this tunnel of sheer love that came down from these fans here. And you can see the most everyone chanting Argentina. Even the French were cheering Argentina. Even during the game, they were cheering Argentina. It's like, it's a wonderful thing to see eight guys come here, play second in their group, and then go out there, score 100 points on Team France, which is a very strong team, and hold them to 300. They made Kelly and David work really hard points. The cleaner had to work. They put it all out there on the track, and they made everyone back home really proud of it. And everyone here, huge Argentina fans. I mean, Team Japan, Ninja Japan, they've won the crowd pretty much, but Argentina are giving a run for their money. And it's been a beautiful thing to watch. And I spoke moments ago with Guerrero, who's from Harm City in Baltimore, and he was saying thank you for all the sponsors. I'm happy for any team that goes on that track and puts everything out there. That's what I'm here about.
And there it is. It really is that simple, ladies and gents. This is why we do this. Thank you very much for being with us. We'll continue the action soon after a quick break, and we'll see you back on the track soon.